It's such a pleasure to be here. I remember, Honorable Minister, that I was here about 16 years ago for the earlier NDA government when the first draft national housing policy was created, and it was just presented over here through FICCI and also the scrapping of the ULC Act. And I was here sitting in the chair which Mr. Naveen Raveja is now occupying, and we had the opportunity to be able to share those dreams which became reality within 2 years. And we brought down interest rates from 16% HDFC to 8.5% within 6 months of the resolution done. And I see the same magic in the Honorable Minister since I've been dealing with him, and he's taken over the chair of this office, and it's such a beautiful thing to see. I remember 6 weeks from, before 4 weeks, I think, from the time he took up chair, he brought a policy with six policy measures on public-private partnership, something which was languishing for years and came on to the floor of the thing and passed and declared in Mumbai. So I was very happy that he did the declaration in Mumbai and now continues to do new and innovative ideas in terms of what it is. The Prime Minister's objective on affordable housing is absolutely clear. The destination of 2022 is an aspiration that we are all working to. And I think with the guidance that you have given, Honorable Minister, I think with FICCI and the other institutions that we do, we should be able to target this area to do it. Yes, the markets are down. There are lots of problems as far as the greenfields and issues are there on the ground, but that doesn't mean anything. Markets will be down, markets will be up, and these changes are bound to take place. And I'm very, very bullish in the fact in the next 5 years, the markets are going to be in a direction in which you can do. On the affordable housing segment, a lot has been said and a lot have been heard, and there is no need to repeat on all the nuances where affordable housing is there. So what are the real challenges? And I think first challenge is already addressed by Mr. Naveen Raheja when he's talked about land being available under the slums. Mumbai, we have 50% of our housing in slums, 50. We have a policy in place. Yes, it's not really worked as well as it is. I think we need to do a paradigm, similar intervention which you are doing here in Delhi. We need to take up one or two great projects with the intervention of the central government in the place called Dharavi or in places where actually a significant move can be done. So I think that combined with it will clear lands and do it. We have no shortage of lands in Mumbai. You know who's the largest owner of land in Mumbai? Empty land? The Honorable Minister. We have only 4,000 acres of land lying in salt pan lands, unused, which are now presently unused. The policy paper is ready. The governments are ready. We have already got the ideas into place. A lot of these conversions are taking place. We will have 4,000 acres, of which 500 acres are immediately available. The rest of it has coastal issues in terms of CRZ and other things. But 500 acres we have, which means 5 lakh houses in the EWS scheme can be started in the next 3 months and completed in the next 3 years if we really had a mission statement to do it. So land is not in shortage. Okay, further, what about the rest of the people? Forget the EWS alone and taking one of the segments there. Thanks to the state government led by Mr. Devendra Fadnavis, we are doing a cross-harbour bridge. We are creating a metro. We are creating a Navi Mumbai airport. All the infrastructure will add 170 kilometers of metro in the next 5 years, which means we double the suburban railway track of Mumbai in the next 5 to 7 years, of which 70% of the funding is already in place through JICA. So we will open up in the next 5 years. This is for Delhi developers, just to tell you, that we are going to add land for the purposes of development equal to the land of whole of Mumbai. So right from Navi Mumbai up to Panvel, up to Karjat, we are opening up enough lands, and there is a railway track coming up between Panvel and Karjat, so we'll add enough land. So land, which has been a tremendous shortage as far as the island city of Mumbai is concerned, in the next 5 years, we'll see a paradigm. Now, I'm talking about the constraints in the biggest and most difficult city in the country, because we are an island city. We are surrounded by water in three sides, but what the new connections of Cross Harbour Bridge, the metro connectivity, the Navi Mumbai Airport, the connectivity which we are now planning to do, and revision with small pan lands and slums which we are doing, if we take these five segments together, we have a solution for the most difficult city in India called Mumbai. And I mention this because I wanted to state very clearly that the policies which the Honorable Minister and the government have put together have certainly been a paradigm to make this initiative and set the spark. What is not yet done is to see that the rollout happens. One of the big things which has happened in the state government, again with the leadership with your ministry, is the ease of doing business. A lot of changes have taken place in the municipal corporation where they have put deadlines in terms of giving approvals to that, not only to mention deadlines. The Honorable Minister, Mr. Fadnavis, has brought about the Right to Services Act, which means that the public servant, the services, are bound to complete a certain service in a specified time. The short point is that if they do not do it, the particular service officer will be penalized if he does not do it and does not give adequate reason for that. What I wanted to mention to you, Honorable Sir, is that we in FICCI are fully supportive of you. We in NAREDCO are also supportive because I also am a part of that organization. I need to commit that to you again. And the fact is that with the paradigm that we do with the public sector and the private sector together, we can achieve this objective. Yes, it is a difficult thing because the target is big and large. Implementation is not so easy at the grassroots level. We need your help and support in all these execution matters which take place. And with your blessing, sir, I'm sure we'll meet the target. We are here to support you. I want to say that the direction is right in all the policy measures. Execution is what we need support with. Thank you very much. Thank you for listening to me. It's a great day, wonderful day to be over here. Thank you very much.